one is Arsen Kovach. He's right up there, high in the Separatist command.
Intel says he's the butcher of Borjami. Wiped that village clean, then burned it to the ground. About 1,500 dead. I've got 1,500 Georgian lari.
That's what? 40 cents to the dollar?
I'd like to nail the bills to that son of a bitch's chest and write payment for Borjami across his face.
Yeah, that would make it crystal clear that you kill innocent civilians, you got a price on your head.
Copy that. Priority two?
Gunrunner. Igor Zaitsev. Apolitical. Russian. Looks to be part of a criminal gang. Mercenary. Just in it for the money.
And the wages of sin are death.
Just like the good book says.
I'll mark him with chapter and verse.
We don't know exactly when Zaitsev is arriving, so you might want to set up an observation point on the hills not far from there. Stealth and awe.
Copy. Out.
Almost there. I've marked a suitable sniping spot on your GPS.
Are you kidding me?
Roger. Investigate and report.
Oh, whatever, dude. I'm gone, totally. Totally, I'm gone. Fuck my life. Dude. Yeah.
on site.
Copy. Get comfy. I'll keep you informed.
Roger. Resume patrol.
Okay, get ready. You got some time before the target arrives. Use your scopes to scout the area.
Multiple tangos in the vicinity.
Copy. Look around and remember to hold your fire before the target arrives.
Roger. They've got a mortar. Seems like they're ready for us.
Too many guards there right now. Stay low.
I see a sniper nest above the checkpoint.
They're all well-trained and dangerous bastards. It may be a good idea to take him down before the situation gets hot. Your call.
I didn't do anything. What are you talking about?
I think I got him. The guy looks like Kovac. Fits the description. Waiting for confirmation.
Confirmed. It's Kovac. Target vehicle is approaching your location. About 250 meters. Get ready.
Big guy's getting out of the car. It's Zaitsev. Waiting for confirmation.
Identity confirmed. Wait for a good moment. You may kill two birds with one stone. When ready.
Copy.
Come on. Come on.
Target's dead.
Confirmed. Exfiltrate the area.
I didn't do anything. What are you talking about? What are you talking about? I didn't kill your people. No, 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 no.
We need support.
You don't need support. You do not need support.
Touch and go until I got a clean sight line.
Good job. Eyes like a hawk.
Thanks. Think I should earn a little leeway. Intel reports a couple of sightings of Robert.
John.
He's my brother.
Request denied, soldier. He's not in our deck of cards.
I know.
You cool with that?
Yeah. Cool.
Keep focused, John. You've got enough trouble directly ahead. We've got a ghost presence in the safe house. Movement detectors are throwing up shadows.
How many? An ambush?
Or a raid. Could be that location is blown.
Fuck. Got a big weapons cache, maps, recent intel.
Get over there, but be careful.
God damn it.
Good. Never been afraid of ghosts. Out.
I got him in.
No, fuck. No. No.
Long time no see.
Yeah, it's been...
What?
That's for the shit you pulled in Afghanistan.
Point taken.
Now would be the perfect time to tell me why I'm here.
I've been ordered to destabilize the separatist cells, and neutralize their leadership. I won't lie. I need someone who knows the region.
You better be fucking joking. I thought I made it clear. I'm never working for your government again.
Perfectly clear. There's the real reason. It's Robert. He's here.
Robert? Oh, Robert. So you called me here to go chasing ghosts with you. You know I'm a wanted person in Georgia, right?
Over the past 6 weeks, CIA, BND, and Mossad have all identified a man fitting Robert's description in northern Georgia.
That's it? Jesus, John. You took this assignment because you think he's here, didn't you?
Robert's my brother, Lydia. He's family.
What do you need me to do?
You know this region better than anyone. You're a hell of a fighter. I know I can trust you. What happened between us in Afghanistan, that was a long time ago. I don't know if it still means anything to you, but I'm sorry. I'm sorry I was me, and that it hurt you.
You unbelievable fucking asshole. Deal. I'll help you find your goddamn little brother. I'll hit up a few contacts. Let them know I'm back in the game. I'll be seeing you, Marine.
Another day in paradise. Come on, Lydia. Not you too.
Sweetness and light on the outside, total shit on the inside. But you are a badass killing machine, so maybe that's what it takes.
So, let's get to it then.
Thomas and David Sidemonidze started to unify all the separatist cells. As ever, when brutal ethnic cleansing starts, it brings haters together. There is an emerging Georgian resistance snapping away at the edges of the separatist campaign. In short, sabotage. It's causing disruption. Not very strong, but with a lot of heart.
What's key to bringing them over?
A humanitarian mission. Civilians are being marched to an old cemetery. They're being executed by the separatists. Save them. Resistance intel can help lead us to Thomas and David.
It'll be my pleasure. Out.
Be careful out there.
No.
What's that?
Nope. I didn't do anything. You're not hearing nothing. How come I can't move it? Anyway, what the heck? Let's try now.
Damn. Looks like they're digging their own graves. There's no time to waste.
Okay, I gotta get to the spot as quickly as possible. Take these guys out and rescue civilians. Fuck my life. You are not gonna kill these guys. You know why? 'Cause I'm about to do this. Stop! You're fucking moving! Are you gonna go see your buddy? You gonna go see your buddy? I'm gonna go see your buddy. Come on. I don't know what you're talking about. I did not do that. No, I didn't do nothing. Okay. Bitch. I did not fucking take your goddamn enemy down.
Shit, it's one of ours.
It is not one of yours. What are you? I do not know what you're talking about. I did not kill your enemies. Nope, 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 nope. Whoa, shit. Fuck me in my fucking butt, dude. Look at this bow. Look at this bow. Where do I think you're going? Where do you think you're going? And I think it's clear. I'm gonna go. I'm gonna run. Go rescue the civilians.
I never imagined I'd die like this. Get the hell out of here.
There's
over.
Two soldiers around.
I see the target.
Too risky.
Roger. Take him down.
Perimeter is breached. We have an...
Locate the shooter.
Vehicle's locked. You're a jerk. Gross. Okay. You guys are freaking gross. Where'd you go? I gotta kill all the guard. Oh, there's four guards. Okay. I got this. I got this. I like this sniper. Man. I got this. I got this, motherfucker. I didn't kill. I did not shoot at your guards. No, I don't know what you're talking about. Faggot. Die. I do not know what you're talking about. I did not shoot him. Nope. Mm-mm. Nope. Nope. No. You're not gonna. Oh, hell no. Hell no. Move out of the fucking way.
Locate and neutralize.
Alright. I'm about it. I'm getting back in my spot, kind of. Let you guys calm down.
Enemy must be nearby. Search the perimeter.
Fuck you. I didn't do anything. What are you talking about? What are you talking about? I don't know what you're talking about. I didn't kill no one. Well, you gotta be kidding me. Come on! Get clear! They're inside the...
Locate and neutralize the enemy.
No! Quiet! No! I am not an enemy. You're the enemy. Return to post. I do not know what you're talking about, no. Come on. You would be in the goddamn church, dude.
Don't kill me, I beg you, please, no.
Target's down.
Copy.
The area's clear. You can make a break for it.
Oh, please. We will never forget what you've done for us.
Don't hit my truck! Don't hit my truck!
Lydia. Lydia, do you copy?
I got you, John. Good work.
Fucking heartbreaking. People led to the slaughter like cattle.
But thanks to you, they'll live to fight another day. And you've already hit major intel pay dirt. The Rodki Lions have come to us. Their leader, Koba Nemsadze, gave us Ivan Khrushchev. He's another separatist top lieutenant. Vicious, sadist, pure evil.
But nothing on Tomas or David?
That intel will come. I know Koba will be very useful. He's one of the strongest, most committed resistance leaders. Very easy on the eyes, too.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. Let us just keep moving up the spine of the snake. According to October, you can find Khrushchev in the blocks.
I'm guessing that's one of those Soviet buildings that looks like a prison.
But this one is an apartment building. Crumbling, old, supposedly abandoned. Watch your step. Could be booby-trapped.
Thanks, I...
Save it. Can't afford to lose a valuable asset like you on the ground.
Yeah, right. Out.
John, wait. Kova offered his support in searching for clues on Robert. You did good, John. Out.
Mr. North, this is Kova Nemzadze. I got your contact from our mutual friend, Lydia Yogadze. I wanted to thank you for saving our brothers from certain death. I hate asking for outside help, but if you are willing to help the people of Georgia, I will swallow my pride. Please meet me. I will send you my location.
Jonathan. It's good to finally put a face to the name. Georgia needs your help, Mr. Sniper. Will you help her?
The Rodkey Lions need fuel. Your help is giving them confidence they can save the most vulnerable.
Now, war is one long fucking exercise in triage. Save the most likely to survive, or the ones with the most cash.
Don't be such a goddamn cynic. These are the sick, the elderly, orphans.
And puppies? Don't forget the puppies.
Fuck you.
It's almost too easy to get you pissed off.
Then why do it?
Seems the only way to get your attention.
Just go to the Separatist fuel depot, steal a truck loaded with fuel barrels, and get out.
Choke off Separatist fuel, and feed it to the lions. Will do. Out.
Be careful, John.
Where the fuck is my... Okay, this is fucking... I'm gonna retry that.
Puppies? Don't forget the puppies.
Fuck you.
It's almost too easy to get you pissed off.
Then why do it?
Seems the only way to get your attention.
Just go to the Separatist fuel depot, steal a truck loaded with fuel barrels, and get out.
Choke off Separatist fuel and feed it to the lions. Will do. Out.
Be careful, John.
Why?
Thank you.
Whoa, that was an explosion? I don't think that was... He was sitting by explosion barrel. Okay. There's a couple more guys. Stay right there.
Hey, what's wrong with you? Are you okay?
No. Who's shooting me? No. You need to fuck off. You need to fuck the fuck off. You need to fuck the fuck off right now.
Thank you.
bitch. Don't stick your neck out. Yeah, that's right. Don't stick your neck out, guys. Bitch. Ow. God, jackass. Alright. I think this is the last. Doggone guy. I'm guessing it's gonna be the last guy.
Man, he just vanished.
Yeah, I vanished. Yep, yep, mm-hmm, yep. Clear, huh? There he is, clear. Yeah, that's right. That's right. That's fucking right. Alright.
I see a truck.
You don't see me.
It's loaded with gas cans.
Find the keys to the truck. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. No, I gotta find... Wow, okay. Shit. Fuck you. Yeah, fuck you. Alright, I can probably kill him.
Start talking, or I start breaking things.
No! I'll talk! I'll talk!
Okay, this is kinda weird. Truck now, dude.
Except that they hold them in a church. Now, there was some local press there. We were the only national outlet that sent cameras. We got footage.
My truck now, dude.
You guys, because there were arrests there. I think arrests that were absolutely outrageous, as you'll see for yourself in a second. First of all, let me give you a description of what happened. Six people were arrested Thursday in a disturbance that erupted after police stopped men who hadn't removed their hats and then either entered their church sanctuary or a town hall meeting. Whether the city should begin drawing water again from the Flint River. David, why are you having them in the church? If you've got this weird rules about how you can't have your hat in the church,
great.
You're going to arrest people over that? While they're worried about the poison that's in the water that's affecting their kids and their families? Okay, insanity, but it gets worse. Some people who were cussing in the church during the emotionally raw town hall meeting were also escorted out of the House of Prayer Missionary Baptist Church by police, according to media reports. Actually, let me go to video 2.
I have your fuel in the car.
Jordan Chardon,
take what you need.
TRT
Thank you.
Reporter was there.
You helped
and,
us save a lot of
he
people.
Recorded the, yeah. The police chief, Tim Johnson, saying this. Church, please remove your hats. If you don't know, the ladies, it's okay to wear their hats in the church, but gentlemen cannot wear their hats in the church, so please remove them.
Well, the rocky lines are stuck with you.
What's that supposed to mean?
The fuel run through the rear of the jet, and the astral truck has been hurt. Passengers are safe.
What do you mean I don't have anybody
anymore?
What does that mean? Okay,
or someone like you.
But this is a town hall.
There's no one
they
like me.
They know you're
so
out there, and they're likely to make the lines.
Oh, God forbid.
So, let's ramp it up and make it worthwhile.
You're right, Tom. There's no one else like
you. Having a hat on in a town hall? Okay. And he followed through on that. Tim Johnson later said, there's a couple people that's arrested. There's a couple people cussing in the church, disorderly conduct. So a town hall event. So then almost every town hall, you could have people arrested. If there's too loud, if they were cussing, oh my, ooh, I do be loud, right? Or if they have their hats on. Why'd you have it in a church? Maybe the whole point of having it in a church was to have an excuse to arrest anyone who dared to raise their voice against the government. And Johnson says, I guess they felt like they can do it anyway. That's what they're here for, is to be agitators. It's a town hall! They're there to, yes, agitate the government by asking them and holding them accountable. That's what the whole point of a government town hall is. Like, somehow they came in to do what? Like, oh, I got it. We'll go to the Flint town hall. We'll pretend we're worried about our poison families and the poison that's in the water. But in fact, we'll agitate with our hats. We'll put hats on, and that'll get That's what you really think, Tim Johnson? Oh my god. Alright, now let's begin to show you some of the arrests that happened.
Then do what you're gonna do.
Says it's got a broad range of quote-unquote undesirable behavior, including failing to support your family. It would appear to be the exact opposite there. It could be for prostitution. I don't think so. Peeping Tom. I don't think so. Illegal gambling. I don't think so. Nudity or sexual acts. It has nothing to do with hats or being too loud or slightly annoying the police. That pretty much set a trap for you so that they could arrest you if you complained about what was happening in your government. Interesting. More arrests.
Watch my cuffs. Grab my keys. I got a secure car.
Give the keys.
Who do you want to give the keys to?
Okay.
I got the front seat.
When you're under arrest, sir.
All right, I appreciate it.
Okay.
And I'll see you in court.
Yes, sir.
Johnny, it's not personal.
Yeah, it is.
Got some new intel for me?
New category target. The most wanted. The most dangerous separatist contact. We're talking to him. G-Soc wants to spend the week where
you're in for first.
What about the ICC?
This is American justice. Shoot
first, ask questions later. Yeah, well, I've seen separatist handiwork in the field, so I don't have any questions. Torture and killing of POWs, rape and burning civilians alive.
First target on the most wanted list is Ivan Khrushchev.
Ivan Khrushchev, yeah. Rodkey Lyons said I could find him in the blocks.
New intel has him moving around the complex. He's deeply paranoid and always travels with a heavy escort.
No fancy fool, child. He's now resisting arrest.
Do as much damage as you can and hit him.
Will do. I'm out.
Resisting arrest. I mean, did that look like she's the one that was charged? Did any of these people look like, well, okay, my God, and we're in a hostile situation. Those cop flags are in danger, right? God. It could have. Look, when you start arresting people for no damn reason at all, when they are justifiably angry about what their government is doing, you open up a door so someone actually can't resist significantly violent. Well, then you gotta take escalating. Oh, no, then what are you doing? Why have you escalated in this way? This is more monstrous. You know that for the misdemeanors, they get 90 days in jail for $500 or bottle. If you participate or refuse to disperse from I don't know what they're going to charge them for resisting arrest. These are people who come. disrespecting the church, cussing at the church. That's a crime? Well, death door, hold the town hall of the church. In fact, Jordan Sheridan, who's the investigative reporter that got all that video for you guys, that attended that event, he did his own town hall before. It sparked a whole sit-in that's happening right now in Flint, Michigan. And he looked into it further. Actually, you can't do this and have the church estate intermingle and have a town hall put in these kind of restrictions. That's actually illegal. That's wrong. You can't put what? Okay, can you imagine? Okay, I'm going to do a town hall in a mosque. So that means you can't violate any tenets of Islam, otherwise you'll be arrested. How insane would that be? It's equally insane if you hold a government town hall inside a church and start arresting people for disrespecting the church. Preposterous. Look, these are average Americans that are just literally sick of this. Here, one last, afterwards, Jordan caught up with them as well. One last video to show you guys about that.
We knew there's other stuff in this water, and we still do. Now they're talking bacteria that we talked about 2 years ago. She has not stopped breathing funky wood since August, and it comes on you and it leaves you, and it comes on you and it leaves you. Right now, I gotta apologize, but I'm telling you, man, it's been a long ass.
We need support.
We're done. You know what I'm saying? My own mayor that we fought to get in has totally disenfranchised our residents.
That right there, unfortunately, is America, man. We are tired and we are sick. In this case, literally. And when you go to complain about it, they lay this ambush for you and then arrest you in the hours. It's grotesque. All the videos are up on YouTube.com.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Watch them all and judge for yourself. This is not what America is supposed to be. Young Turks membership, great.
I don't know what you're talking about. I didn't kill no one. No, I didn't kill no one.
I can't see you. Stay in cover.
You're inside a Chipotle burrito where everything is real. Just be real.
Well, I kind of have a thing for musicians.
What about the ICC?
This is American
justice. But that's shoot first, ask questions later. Meals,
yeah, well, I've seen Sephardis handiwork on the field, so I don't have any questions. Torture and killing of POWs, rape and burning civilians alive.
First target on the most wanted list is Ivan Khrushchev.
Ivan Khrushchev, yeah. Rodkey Lyons said I could find him in the blocks.
New intel has him moving around the complex. He's deeply paranoid and always travels with a heavy escort.
No fancy footwork, Jared. In and out for weak weakness. Do as much damage as you can.
Will do. Out.
Don't. Remember to find the crash tool. I sent you its last location. Its GPS is still operational. We covered the data before someone else does.
Roger.
Yeah. You know, your horse already ordered it. So,
with a happy face.
So, when I was little, I worked for, and I got pretty much out of school. So, for us, this is in Jersey, I had to go with other poor kids into a room to get a ticket.
It's heavily guarded. Won't be easy to sneak into the building.
Try to find the other way. Maybe you can take him out from a distance.
They punch the ticket for you, and then, you know, you got to wait. It was embarrassing. Okay, I really, really did not like setting that line to get that ticket, and then standing in line at the lunch counter, and then having the lady punch it. There's kids make fun of you for it, you know, and they laugh at you and they say horrible things, and it causes angst whenever it was lunchtime. Like, oh, it's lunchtime again. Hunger, gotta eat. But I don't want to get humiliated by other kids, right? But this is much worse, where they're saying, we're not going to give you food, we're going to take it away.
You're hungry.
Yeah.
A child's hungry, and they take his food and throw it. It's unbelievable to me, too. When I was a kid, we were poor. I grew up 12 kids. My dad was a cop. And we drank powdered milk. And, no kidding. We were
poor. It's a bluish tinted
no,
milk.
What the fuck?
Gray and blue.
My
mom would literally say, we're not poor, we're middle class. I'm like, Mom, we drink powdered milk. What are fucking poor people drinking? Just the powder?
The water.
So, anyway, I went to Catholic school. And, in Catholic school, they would give you this lunch thing, and you'd have to, pay to give a check, or they had a box that said free.
What the fuck? Incoming.
I saw a kid next to me check the free and put it, and I go, you can just check free, and they'll give you a lunch? And he goes, yeah. Well, I could never afford a lunch, so I always had to make a sandwich.
You need support.
So I checked free, and I put it in, and I got a lunch.
Stay in cover.
For, like, I don't know, 6 months, I got a hot lunch. I was like, yeah, this is great. And then one day, the secretary comes to class and says, Jimmy Dore, you can't get a free lunch anymore. Your dad makes too much money. I go, my dad, I'm wearing two different shoes. What are you talking about? My dad makes too much money. Yeah, my dad's a cop. We have 12 kids. What are you talking about?
You have to pay for
milk. That's what they said. So I couldn't get a free lunch anymore, so I went back to eat less.
We want to include and get reduced.
But isn't this part of the larger overall society? Shaming people for being poor.
So when people get money, they go, I'm so blessed. You're not blessed. You just got money. That doesn't mean Jesus likes you more because he gave you fucking money and he likes people.
It doesn't mean
in fact, Jesus likes the poor better, actually.
That you work harder.
Yeah.
You're smarter. It doesn't mean anything.
None of that.
No, it doesn't mean anything.
It doesn't mean any of that shit. That's exactly right.
Lost eyes on the target. He's somewhere.
No, I'm not. I left. No.
Trump is actually trying to build a wall. the Republicans, and then it's the Congress fucking.
You're there. Are you okay?
I noticed that they were gonna try to get in there despite this Saturday deadline.
Remember, says Trump has more power. Can't even get it passed through Congress.
Shutdown. So now that the White House is back to work, I'm gonna get clean the funding bill and the Republicans.
Return fire. Get him down.
What, really? I can't. Okay, this is fucking retarded.
Suppressing fire on enemy position.
And you've actually been doing some research and reporting on how the president has done so far. He certainly thinks that he's been quite productive in the first 100 days.
Stay in cover!
What have you found out?
Well, this first 100 days mark is something that Franklin Roosevelt first came up with in one of his fireside chats. It was actually 100 days after Congress came into session, not administration. And
the government's shutting down again.
Open fire! Open fire!
76 laws. It was in the beginning of the New Deal. Really, Congress and the president worked together like never before, and every other president has always been measured by that.
Return fire! Pin him down!
Even John Kennedy, in his inaugural address, laid out all his priorities.
Now turned social justice warrior, who had a show 20 years ago
about science geared for kids, and now he's back with a new series on Netflix titled Bill Nye Save the World. Please, Bill, tell us, what are we about to see in this amazing skit about science?
So, you guys, seriously, this next thing I feel is very special. This is a cool segment. You know this woman from Crazy Ex-Girlfriend. Please give it up for Rachel Bloom.
You get it? Why must she choose between John or Joyce? She might be bisexual. She might be sexual questioning. Please just continue.
Got a visual in question.
Target confirmed. That's our guy. Find a spot to take him out.
Careful, don't stick your neck out.
We're in the mental hospital. And no, I'm not joking. This is how the liberals are trying to brainwash kids now into having sex with their friends. Boys or girls, it doesn't matter. Just do it. Unfortunately, the insanity didn't stop there. In another episode, Bill Nye introduced these ice cream cone characters who were discussing experimenting with their sexuality, which culminated in them having a giant orgy.
Come on, for a minute. Nobody wants just one flavor of ice cream.
I do.
Haven't you ever wanted to be in a Neapolitan?
I can't.
Come on. It's natural.
Yes, those different flavors of ice cream are trying to convince Vanilla, who's depicted as a boring heterosexual, to have a bisexual orgy with them. While many liberals who have the minds of mentally challenged children are enjoying the show, not all liberals find it entertaining or interesting. Gizmodo writes, if you're skeptical about human-caused climate change or the safety of vaccines, would being berated in front of a live studio audience by a bombastic old man make you change your mind? Then congratulations! Bill Nye's new Netflix show, Bill Nye Saves the World, is literally just for you. I was excited when I heard the new science show for adults was hitting Netflix, especially when starring the 90s kid parody of Bill Nye. But either the science guy's joke has
on. I moved away from the area. Is she gonna fuck come over here, Shinra? How's she a fucking ass?
Lost eyes on the target. Ordering mortar strike on enemy position.
No matter how much I accomplish during the ridiculous standard of the
first. Defensive positions! Mortar fire incoming!
Fuck. Fuck. No. Fuck off. Dude. Fag.
Open fire! Open fire!
Fuck you.
Got a visual on Khrushchev.
Target confirmed. That's our guy. Find a spot to take him out.
Open fire!
Dun 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 dun. I am not here. You cannot find me. Yeah, go. Of course.
Be careful, don't stick your neck out.
Alright, let's sit.
God.
We need mortar fire. Mortar fire incoming. Reporting casualty. Eyes on Tangle. Opening fire. Enemy presence confirmed. Northwest. There he is. Shoot him.
I'm just gonna swap this. That way. I'm not out here. What are you talking about? I left. I left a long time ago. That's right, I just finished, yep. Mm-hmm. Watching me, dude. Why are you watching me? Oh God. Motherfucking crazy.
He's gone.
Where is he?
UKIA.
I'm gonna get a clear
enemy
shot.
Down. Wow! Get back up on the fucking window, you little stupid piece of shit! Come on. Dude.
Why are you fucking watching?
You died.
No, we're from mortar.
Why is there so many steam and sulfur? What the heck? What the heck?
What?
There's another steam and sulfur.
You betrayal. Alright. I know where he is. He's in the window. So I'm going to get in position before I use the drone. You do not have a visual on me. Come on.
Hauling gasoline from Polito Bay to Los
Angeles. Oh my God, dude. It's not a video game.
Yes, it is!
Not a video game.
A video game.
No, it isn't.
It's an open world video game.
It's not a video game.
Uh-huh. Yes, it is!
We're under attack! Get the deck!
a visual on Crestview.
Target confirmed. That's our guy. Find a spot to take him out.
What? That's right. We got 12 course.
Are you kind of kidding me? What the fuck are you watching? This is fucking. He stole it from Epic Mealtime.
Have the separatists by the short hairs.
You got it. Really have too much.
Jason, can you get there? Wait for the details. Out.
Oh shit! Here comes Pac-Man. Produce that bacon. Time to drain off that grease so we can save it for later use. Probably some sensible uses.
Candy bacon. I think they're gonna cook it some more. Gross, dude.
Huh?
That is gross.
This house.
houses in Spring City, Pennsylvania, a small town a little west of Philadelphia. This house used to be a bank building that was built in 1872, which is now my home. When I decided to purchase it, I knew the building well because my very first job started out as a teller in 1972 in this bank. At the time I purchased it in 1989, it was actually a working bank. They had just closed it, almost like they closed it for the weekend. The telebooths were still here. The paperwork was still here. The vault existed. All the safe deposit boxes were still here. So I started to go through things and remodel. I had keys for a lot of the safe deposit boxes. And as I started to open them, I started to find bills, coins, bills that were actually printed in the basement of this bank. Old savings book, passbook information, ledgers, not worth anything unfortunately now, but I like to keep it just as memorabilia. I tried to preserve as much of the bank as possible when converting into a house, but I knew I had to make it livable. I designed the layout, but mostly
that's a bouncing Betty. Type armor piercing against armored targets. Oh my god.
Foxy. Where'd Foxy go? He was in here. Where'd Foxy go?
He's on my bed still.
Foxy, come here. Come here.
Foxy.
You got more on the satellite comms?
Yeah. JSOC wants you to redirect the broadcast signal.
Manually?
We've got an approximation of the plans. You'll have to reposition the radio telescopes.
That it?
It's no cakewalk, John. You'll have to infiltrate a heavily guarded antenna array. This is a key facility for them. They'll quickly catch on about what happened, but before they do, we'll access all their archives.
There's likely to be some chatter about Robert.
All I can promise is to keep our ears open.
Nah, Frank. He's too stubborn to die. Please.
All right. Ears open, John.
Why are you guys sleeping? It's Tuesday, dude. Our show demo's like at 5:30.
William, you know what? You want to know what time the Saturday start time went down this last Saturday? 8:20. I know, right? I told him. I betcha this Saturday, Memphis is going to be on time, and I'm not gonna need it earlier. Freaking. There's 1.5 positions. 1.5 positions of Panasonic. Any scientists? This I can do.
Eyes on the sky. We have a bogey.
Eyes on Tango. Opening fire. Visual on the enemy. Casualty!
Reporting casualty. Locate the shooter.
Why are they aiming up?
Where did he go?
Hey man, I'm gonna calm down. What are you guys up down there? Doubt it. Hey man, I just need to reposition your satellites. Just let me reposition your satellites and I'll leave. Escape. I will leave nice and peaceful if you just let me reposition your satellites. I will not kill any more of you guys. Those guys wanted to die. They said, oh. Fuck that.
On the fucking disc.
Medium armor. Ooh, sweet. Okay. Just let me read. Okay. I kinda fucked up on that mission. On that part, you know. On this mission. Good. Okay, just keep walking, pacing back and forth. Do not look at the dead guy that's on the ground. Get away from me.
There's no one here. Roger, return to post.
Intruder.
You quit. Oh God, William.
They just copied Ghost Recon.
No, they didn't.
In the last two, you didn't have an arrow, a bow arrow.
Yeah, you did. You had to unlock it.
Who even makes that game anyway?
City Interactive. Thanks to Ron. William. Mom has a fucking red light ticket. Right there.
Why?